His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa held a telephone call with Russian President Vladimir Putin, where His Majesty congratulated him on his election as President of Russia, wishing him success. For his part, the Russian President congratulated His Majesty on the occasion of the holy month of Ramadan. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received in the presence of the personal representative of His Majesty the King, Sheikh Abdullah bin Hamad Al Khalifa at Sakhir Palace, well-wishers from the people of Muharraq Governorate on the occasion of the holy month of Ramadan, within the framework of the meeting that His Majesty is keen to hold with the people of Bahrain during the holy month.
وصول جيد حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك المعظم.
السلام عليكم. السلام عليكم. السلام عليكم.
The citizens greeted His Majesty the King, expressing congratulations and best wishes to him on the occasion and wishing him many happy returns with abundant health and happiness, and Bahrain and its people further progress and prosperity. His Majesty welcomed the attendees, congratulated them on the occasion, and exchanged friendly conversations with them.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المعظم حفظه الله ورعاه، أصحاب السمو، أصحاب المعالي والسعادة، أيها السيدات والسادة، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته، وكل عام وأنتم بخير بمناسبة حلول شهر رمضان المبارك. خير ما نبدأ به تلاوة عطرة من القرآن الكريم يتلوها على مسامعنا القارئ علي صلاح عمر.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات سندخلهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا وعد الله حقا ومن أصدق من الله قيلا. ليس بأمانيكم ولا أماني أهل الكتاب، من يعمل سوءا يجز به ولا يجد له من دون الله وليا ولا نصيرا. ومن يعمل من الصالحات من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فأولئك يدخلون الجنة ولا يظلمون نقيرا. ومن أحسن دينا ممن أسلم وجهه لله وهو محسن واتبع ملة إبراهيم حنيفا واتخذ الله إبراهيم خليلا. ولله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وكان الله بكل شيء محيطا. صدق الله العظيم. بارك.
كلمة أهالي محافظة المحرق تلقيها نيابة عنهم الدكتورة فاطمة بنت محمد البلوشي.
Then Dr. Fatma Lebloushi delivered the speech of the people of Muharraq, in which she conveyed the congratulations of the people of Muharraq on the occasion of the holy month, wishing His Majesty many happy returns. She said that the people of Muharraq remain loyal to the Al-Khalifa family and recalled the achievements made during the 25 years of the prosperous era of His Majesty at the local, regional, and international levels. She said that Muharraq has produced many Bahraini competencies in various specialities. She also expressed pride in His Majesty's order to preserve the historical and cultural identity of the buildings and cities of Bahrain and working to revive Isa al-Kabir Palace, which His Majesty will adopt as one of the main headquarters of his workplace. She thanked His Majesty for the achievements and projects made in Muharraq, including housing projects and services, the construction of parks, the new ring road, Bahrain International Airport, and the Galali Coast. She stated that during the past 25 years, many achievements were made, especially in the human rights represented in Bahrain, ascending to many international conventions related to human rights and establishing the National Institution for Human Rights, the Commission for the Rights of Prisoners and Detainees, the General Directorate Secretariat of Grievances, and the Special Investigation Unit, in addition to issuing new legislation such as the Penal Code and Alternative Measures and the Law Restorative Justice for Children and the implementation of the Open Presence Program. She recalled His Majesty's keenness on tolerance, peaceful coexistence, and dialogue between all religions and sectors. She recalled the achievements made to achieve Bahrain's 2030 vision. Lebloushi said that thanks to the support of His Majesty and Her Royal Highness, the wife of His Majesty the King, President of the Supreme Council for Women, Princess Sabika bint Ibrahim Al Khalifa, Bahraini women have assumed many senior positions locally and internationally. She expressed pride in the role of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and the approach and policies of the government in achieving balance in the economic field and implementing development projects. She commended the role of His Highness Sheikh Abdullah in developing environmental projects and supporting advanced ideas in this field. She hailed the local, regional, and international sports achievements of all Bahraini teams thanks to His Majesty the King's representative for humanitarian work in Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and the first Deputy Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, the Chairman of the General Sports Authority, and President of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa. She valued the efforts of the National Guard and the Ministry of Interior at advanced military and security levels and recalled the sacrifices of the fallen servicemen. والنخوة العربية المتأصلة في نفوس قاطنيها. ويشرفنا نحن في محافظة المحرق أن نفتخر ونعتز بأمر جلالتكم السامي بالمحافظة على الهوية التاريخية والثقافية لمباني ومدن البحرين، ويأتي في طليعتها إحياء قصر عيسى الكبير الذي ستعتمدونه بإذن الله كأحد المقار الرئيسة لجلالتكم، ومعه إعادة تأهيل الأحياء المعروفة بمدينة المحرق التي تتطلعون حفظكم الله إلى عودة أهاليها إليها، تكريماً لذلك المجد الوطني المشهود في وطن الطيبة والكرامة. تلك الأوامر السامية التي أفرحت قلوب رجالات المحرق ونسائها كبارها وصغارها، حيث ستستعيد من خلالها المحرق منارتها الشامخة في الريادة والتقدم وتشرفها بمقدم جلالتكم إلى العاصمة القديمة ومهد العلم والتعليم. صاحب الجلالة، نرفع إليكم باسم الأهالي الشكر العظيم على المنجزات والمشاريع التي تحققت على أرض محافظة المحرق، فمن جامع الشيخ حمد إلى كافة دور العبادة التي تلقى كل الرعاية والاهتمام من لدنكم، إلى المشاريع والخدمات الإسكانية التي طالت الجميع، وأيضاً إنشاء الحدائق والمنتزهات والطريق الدائري الجديد، وفرحتنا بالمعلم الحضاري والاقتصادي المتمثل بمطار البحرين الدولي والذي ستكتمل الصورة الجميلة له بافتتاح الصالة الملكية الجديدة، وساحل قلالي الذي يعتبر من المشاريع السياحية
والخدمية المتميزة، وكذلك مسار اللؤلؤ الذي يقف شاهداً على عراقة وتراث البحرين، والمزيد من المشاريع التنموية المتميزة التي يقوم بها القطاع الخاص والأهلي لتكون المحرق درة بين المدن ونموذج يحتذى به. وعلى صعيد مملكة البحرين، فقد حصلت طفرة كبيرة خلال 25 عاماً من عهد جلالتكم على كافة الأصعدة، وعلى الأخص في مجال حقوق الإنسان. فبتوجيهاتكم انضمت المملكة إلى العديد من الاتفاقيات الدولية ذات العلاقة بحقوق الإنسان، وتبعاً لذلك أنشئت العديد من الآليات الوطنية مثل المؤسسة الوطنية لحقوق الإنسان ومفوضية حقوق السجناء والمحتجزين والأمانة العامة للتظلمات ووحدة التحقيق الخاصة، بالإضافة إلى إصدار تشريعات جديدة كقانون العقوبات والتدابير البديلة وقانون العدالة الإصلاحية. وكانت وما زالت كل تلك الإنجازات محل تقدير من قبل المنظمات والأجهزة الدولية ذات العلاقة. ونستذكر في هذا المقام اهتمام جلالتكم وحرصكم الدائم على التسامح والتعايش السلمي والحوار بين كافة الأديان والمذاهب والأطياف، حتى أصبحت البحرين واحة أمن وأمان لكل من تطأ قدماه تراب هذا الوطن الغالي. وعلى الصعيد المحلي، فإننا نثمن عالياً مسيرة العطاء في قواتنا المسلحة الباسلة والحرس الوطني ووزارة الداخلية من مستويات عسكرية وأمنية متطورة، حيث سجلت هذه المؤسسات التي نفخر بها ملاحم وطنية محل تقدير واعتزاز من الجميع. ونستذكر بهذه المناسبة شهداؤنا الأبرار الذين سطروا أروع وأسمى التضحيات في سبيل الذود عن تراب الوطن. وفي مجال التنمية المستدامة، لابد من الإشارة إلى ما تحقق من إنجازات في كافة المجالات تحقيقاً لرؤية البحرين 2030، ومن ضمن ذلك ما تحقق من تطوير واضح في مجال التعليم والصحة وفي مجال العمل والاقتصاد والتنمية الاجتماعية وفي البيئة والإسكان والقضاء ومختلف الخدمات المقدمة للمواطنين. ونالت المرأة البحرينية نصيبها الكبير في مختلف القطاعات، فبفضل دعم جلالتكم ورعاية صاحبة السمو الملكي الأميرة سبيكة بنت إبراهيم آل خليفة قرينة جلالتكم رئيسة المجلس الأعلى للمرأة، حيث تبوأت المرأة البحرينية العديد من المناصب العليا محلياً ودولياً لتساهم بما لديها من علم ومعرفة وإخلاص في بناء الوطن والرقي به في أعلى المراتب. إننا ومن خلال تشرفنا بهذا اللقاء حفظكم الله نشيد ونعرب عن اعتزازنا بالدور الكبير لصاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد رئيس مجلس الوزراء حفظه الله في نهج الحكومة الموقرة وسياساتها الحكيمة في تحقيق التوازن في المجال الاقتصادي وتنفيذ المشاريع التنموية، وقيادة سموه وحكمته المتميزة في إدارة الحكومة الموقرة على كافة الصعد. ونثمن أيضاً دور المجلس الأعلى للبيئة بقيادة سمو الشيخ عبد الله بن حمد آل خليفة في تطوير المشاريع البيئية ودعم الأفكار المتقدمة في هذا المجال. ويشرفنا أن نفخر بما تحقق من إنجازات رياضية على المستوى المحلي والإقليمي والدولي لكافة المنتخبات والفرق البحرينية بفضل توجيهات جلالتكم ودعمكم للرياضة البحرينية، ومن خلال السياسة المتميزة التي ينتهجها سمو الشيخ ناصر بن حمد آل خليفة رئيس المجلس الأعلى للشباب والرياضة، وسمو الشيخ خالد بن حمد آل خليفة رئيس الهيئة العامة للرياضة رئيس اللجنة الأولمبية. صاحب الجلالة، الحضور الكرام، في ختام كلمتي أقول هذه هي المحرق، وهؤلاء أهلها الأوفياء باقون على العهد الذي قطعوه على أنفسهم وتشربت به نفوسهم بشأن مواصلة البذل والعطاء والتضحية والوفاء والإخلاص في بناء الوطن وعزته وكرامته. دمتم جلالتكم ذخراً وسنداً للمحرق ولكافة مدن وقرى البحرين وللمواطنين ولكل من يقيم على تراب هذا الوطن الغالي. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Then His Majesty the King received a commemorative gift.
مبارك إن شاء الله، كل عام وأنتم بخير.
حكاية الحرة غالية وعزيزة علينا، تشهد نمو بعد آخر في السنوات القادمة القليلة، مو بالكثيرة القليلة، لأنها تستاهل وتستحق، وأهاليها نفس الشيء ولازم يعودون لها. إن شاء الله نفرح نشوف الجميع في المحرق. اي نعم، كل عام وانتم بخير. مشكورين.
His Majesty expressed appreciation for the honorable stances and patriotic sentiments showed by the people of the Muharraq Governorate towards their homeland, praising the pioneering efforts and contributions made by its people in the history of national action and the country's cultural development. His Majesty affirmed that Ramadan is an occasion during which the values of communication and harmony are safeguarded through the exchange of fraternal visits that have characterized the people of Bahrain throughout their ancient history, based on solidarity, coexistence, and human tolerance. His Majesty the King recalled the role of the first generation of Bahraini men, their tireless work and the services they provided to the nation for its development, adding that their current generation is following this path to enhance the process of construction and development that is witnessing in all fields. His Majesty affirmed that the kingdom will remain strong in its national unity and proud of its cultural heritage, and will continue to build bridges of cooperation with all countries. He expressed thanks for the sincere and benevolent efforts and endeavors being made for Bahrain's development, wishing everyone many happy returns of the occasion, and that the kingdom would be blessed with security, safety, and prosperity. The people of the Muharraq Governorate congratulated His Majesty the King on the occasion of the Silver Jubilee of His Majesty's accession to the throne, expressing pride in the kingdom's achievements during the prosperous reign of His Majesty the King over 25 years of civilizational and developmental achievements at all levels and as a result of the visions of His Majesty. They expressed pleasure at meeting His Majesty and appreciation for his communication approach that establishes with the people of Bahrain. They expressed thanks and gratitude for His Majesty's care and interest in Muharraq Governorate and meeting the aspirations and needs of its people through the housing projects, educational edifices, and the modern health facilities established as a result of the directives of His Majesty. The governor of Muharraq, Salman al-Manna'i, expressed thanks, gratitude, and appreciation to His Majesty the King for meeting with the people of the governorate. He expressed appreciation to His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister for the government's efforts and for His Royal Highness's leadership of Team Bahrain towards economic growth and prosperity through Bahrain's future vision. The governor conveyed the sentiments of the citizens who affirmed their allegiance to His Majesty the King and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister. The Supreme Council of Health, SCH, in cooperation with SM Company, organized a ceremony to launch the Manama Health Conference and Exhibition, which will be held in December. Present were the Chairman of the Council, Lieutenant General Sheikh Dr. Mohammed bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, the Minister of Health, Dr. Jalila Hassan, the CEO of Government Hospitals, Dr. Maryam Al Jalahma, and the head of the Manama Health Conference and Exhibition. On the occasion, the SCA chairman affirmed Bahrain's welcome of holding such medical events to review the latest findings of scientific studies in this vital sector, which is the top priority of His Majesty the King and the continuous follow-up by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister, who always directs to strengthen the health sector and exchange experiences. For her part, Al-Jalahma affirmed the success of the event in its last two editions in enhancing cooperation between Bahrain and other countries. A joint coordination meeting was held between the government and the legislative authority to restructure government support. The Representatives' Council side was chaired by the first Deputy Speaker, Abd al-Nabi Salman, while the Shura Council side was chaired by the second Deputy Speaker, Dr. Jihad al-Fadl. The government delegation was chaired by the Minister of Parliament Affairs, Ghanem al-Bu'aini. During the meeting, the two sides expressed keenness on reaching consensus based on the basic principles of support agreed upon based on the previous joint coordination meetings. The legislative authority reviewed its proposed vision for the six government subsidies and the estimated cost, which is aimed at improving citizens' standard of living and covers people with disabilities, a social security and living improvement allowance for retirees, a high cost allowance and rent allowance, and food commodity support. The government team affirmed its keenness to develop the efficiency of the financial support system for citizens in cooperation with the legislative authority, noting its interest in studying the proposed scenarios for the six financial subsidies with the competent authorities and the government. The Chief of Public Security and Chairman of the National Civil Emergency Management Committee, Lieutenant General Tariq Al-Hassan, issued a statement marking the Arab Day for Disaster Risk Reduction under the theme Resilient Arab Infrastructure Resistant to Disasters, to focus on their efforts to limit disaster risk through sustainability and development. Al-Hassan stated that Bahrain is dedicated to achieving sustainable development goals and the SINDAY framework for disaster risk reduction through a government action plan. He added that the updated national emergency strategy, shaped by the Minister of Interior and Chairman of the Civil Defense Council, General Sheikh Rashid Al Khalifa, is the cornerstone to reinforce Bahrain's capabilities in confronting disasters and emergencies through an advanced national system. The Chief of Public Security affirmed that the National Civil Emergency Management Committee plays a prominent role in raising awareness among members of society about the risks of disasters and how to prevent and prepare for their adverse effects. Al-Hassan asserted that the National Civil Emergency Management Committee works through a system in partnership with local, regional and international bodies to develop a national and regional system concerned with reducing disaster risks at all stages by a national and regional plan that sets the necessary rules and principles. The Ministry of Interior's Under Secretary for Nationality, Passports and Residence Affairs, Sheikh Hisham bin Abdul Rahman Al Khalifa, stated that 125,000 copies of e-passports have been issued since the launch of the service under the patronage of the Minister of Interior, General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, in March 2023. He said that the e-passport is a turning point in facilitating citizens' traveling procedures. Bahrain's e-passport has won several international awards thanks to its distinction from other passports. The General Directorate of Traffic continues its law enforcement campaigns to arrest individuals for practicing public transportation activity without a license, which consisted of transporting paid passengers without a license issued by the Ministry of Transportation and Telecommunications and in unlicensed vehicles. The General Directorate of Traffic confirmed that in association with the Ministry of Transportation and Telecommunications concerned with issuing licenses for public means of transportation, legal steps were taken and violators were referred to the public prosecution.